We're on the set of the Rich Mullins film, and the guy that I knew right when my buddy Bodie was showing me who was going to be showing up is James Kyson, because my wife got me into Heroes. Ando, it's been 3-4 years since you guys wrapped.
Yeah, I mean, we finished the show 2010, so yeah, it's been a couple years.
And so how did you, like the Rich Mullins script, how did that whole story take place where you found out about it?
Well, one of my staff in L.A. Got a hold of this script. And,
where are they?
I had met David back in 2006 at our artist retreat, and saw him do stand-up. He was doing stand-up in some improv comedy, and I just thought he was really funny. And, you know, we kept in touch here and there. And then Dave messaged me and said, I'm directing this film. And I didn't know the two were related, so, you know, I was really excited to hear that. And so we met up, and we reconnected and caught up, and I loved the script and the story, and I felt like I had heard of the name, but I wasn't really too familiar with Rich Mullins, so I started doing some research and just found the story really fascinating, and the music was very powerful. So yeah, so I decided to, you know, come on board.
You know, you land a role. A lot of actors, you say, out in L.A. aren't as fortunate to have gotten a role that ended up, you know, NBC, huge spot. To land an awesome role, but then for actors in general, how tough is that to go long periods of time where you're still working, they just might not see you?
You know, they say it's more of a marathon than a sprint, and I think your career is sort of defined by, you know, quality and longevity. And so, you know, there is a sense of every project comes to an end, and when it's over, you are sort of back to the drawing board in some sense, and I think that's the uniqueness of our craft. And Heroes was a great show to be part of, and I learned a lot from it. And you know, this year has been a very big blessing, and I think a lot of the roles that I have taken on lately have been maybe not as commercial, but definitely satisfying.
Mm. Me too.
Like with this guy.
I love you, James.
Love you, Bodie.
I need your keys because your car is totally blocking like the next shot.
Okay.
So it'd be really good if you don't embarrass everybody and yourself today and get your car moved.
Okay. Oh, right in the Joy FM bag, right to your left, behind the curtain. Just being out in L.A. just as an actor, when you guys see scripts and stuff like that, obviously there are some that are those of faith out in L.A., those that are not, but does it matter for an actor? Do they just read a script? And
for me, story always comes first. And, you know, what drew me to this script was that it was about a very gifted, talented guy who's gone through a lot of bumps on the road in life, and was just very had an honest and raw perspective on life, and just felt like it was a story that needed to be told and shared. So, you know, to me, it didn't matter if it was faith-based or not, and I don't even really categorize this as sort of with that type of label. I just feel like it's a great story of redemption, of failure, and finding yourself again, and it's got great music in it, you know. So I think it's got an appeal that many people can relate to.
Cool. Where will people see you next that you're working on?
I'm heading back to Los Angeles and filming a pilot called Introducing Miss Jones. And then a couple projects in talks for the fall, so we'll see how the year plays out.
I just love it when talent meets humility, and it's been cool hanging with you today because you definitely have that, so it's great having you here.
Yeah, thank you. My pleasure.
There is the silence in the Badlands, and over Kansas the whole universe was still. By the whisper of a breath.